The Democratic National Convention kicks off tonight, and it could spell trouble for the stock market, according to our next guest. Joining us now on the CNBC Newsline is Terry Haynes of Pangaea Policy. He's the founder of that company. Terry, I'm curious what you think we're going to hear from the campaign this week, because the former vice president and Senator Bernie Sanders launched a 110-page manifesto in July that pretty much laid out all of these progressive presidential policy positions. So what do you think we could learn this week that's new?
Well, I think what happens, Kayla, is that a lot of those policy positions get adopted as the official Democratic platform. And most times platforms don't mean anything, really. But I think this is the rare case where it does mean something, because markets generally think that Biden is likelier to win than not. Markets, I think, comfort themselves that Vice President Biden has been a centrist throughout his political career. And I think there's going to be a little bit of a wake-up call this week when they figure out that, well, this is not going to be running or governing as centrists. Biden and Harris intend to run and govern as progressives, or as I sometimes call them, progressive light. And that's going to introduce, among other things, the potential for large tax increases. One source calls it a $4 trillion tax that might reduce GDP long term by 1.5% and cost the top 1% of earners almost 8% in after-tax income. There was discussion even back in the Biden-Sanders document about a new Fed requirement to elevate racial equity. Nothing against the Fed considering this, but it is an uncertainty about how to rejigger the Fed's mandate. Those kinds of things, I think, are going to start to concern markets as we move into the fall.
So Terry, even if the market is surprised this week coming or further forward, the way in which the Democratic ticket campaigns, do you think they'd also end up governing in the same way, whether by intention or the restrictions that they might face unless they get a clean sweep?
Well, that's the excellent question, Wilfred. And the answer is it depends. It depends on whether you have Biden and Harris as president and vice president alone with a continued divided Washington. And I think a divided Washington continues to be the base case here, by the way. But if things this fall move towards an all-Democratic Washington, that's the scenario in which Biden and Harris could actually make a lot of this happen. And, today I tend to be very non-consensus about the election because I think it's only about 20% likely that you get an all-Democratic Washington. But we're a long way from the finish line. And if it looks more and more like that going into late September, early October, you're going to see the markets react accordingly.
Terry, regardless of what poll you look at from recent days, a handful show the Biden-Harris campaign's lead is shrinking over the Trump-Pence ticket. I'm curious what you think that portends for the rest of the campaign season and how high that makes the stakes for this week for the Democrats.
I've long thought that the polls were going to tighten substantially, Kayla, and that's already starting to happen, number one. Number two, I would urge investors not to pay a great deal of attention to those polls, and nothing against the people that do them. But they are national polls of registered voters when the election gets decided state by state among likely or actual voters. So the race, generally what's going to happen here is the race is going to tighten further, number one. Number two, most voting advantages are going to be in voting totals for Biden and Harris are going to be in coastal states that are already blue and are already in their column. So you're going to be down to a very tight election. And the market stakes are going to be, there's going to be a substantial amount of market nervousness a month from now. And that's probably going to continue right through the election, not least because both sides now, both Trump and Democrats, are starting to put pressure on the sanctity of the elections themselves. So there's going to be an additional nervousness, as I know there already is, about whether the election's actually going to get resolved on November the 3rd.